yum. Can you guess what that is? Pumpkin spice latte, obviously, for fall. Basic bitch. Of fall. You know, this is the time of the year where a lot of people start to get seasonal depression. It's not as prominent in the summers as it is in the winters because there's a direct correlation of light hours, which basically means the hours in the day that the sun is out. So yeah, it's kind of connected to light sensitivity, and I am for sure more sensitive to light. So the reason I wanted to put this video together is because I have noticed some huge changes that have occurred in my life. I don't feel upset or as sad as I usually do during this time around. I didn't even do too much. Like, I haven't changed too much. So usually every single year I completely suffer from like seasonal depression. I don't know. I go into this little shell of mine when like school or work is starting. I don't go out with my friends. I don't call my grandparents anymore. Like, I get kind of depressed. And I was like, damn, that's such a waste of fucking life, because hello, I live in Calgary and it's not always summertime here. So there's something I gotta do to fix this right away. And these aren't even things I intentionally did that changed how my body and mind react to the winter time, but these are just things I did this year, especially since this year has just been a huge year of just fucking growth for me in every way. It's so weird. I don't even know what the fuck's happening with the stars. I don't really know what the fuck's happening, honestly. But I wanted to share some of these tips because they're very small, minor changes that everyone can make in their lives that I don't think we'll know about. And it's mindset changes. It has nothing to do with learning something. It's more like allowing yourself to be open to different mindset changes, if that makes sense. So, doesn't have to make sense right now. It's all good if that shit confused you. Let me go into the tips and tricks and tell you guys how I have become more of a vibrant person. Pumpkin spice tea break. Okay, step one. You know how we grew up and we went to school, we worked in workplaces, and the number one thing that a lot of us probably were thrown into without any explanation is competition, competitiveness. Yes, human species need to be competitive and constantly push themselves. People thrive on it. But one thing that we were not taught in school, or I guess taught anywhere, is that you don't need to put your mental health on the line for your work or for your school. No one's gonna tell you this. Let me tell you why. Duh, they're trying to make money off of you. Instead, what they're gonna do is have mental health awareness sessions on company time, telling you stuff you probably already know, and then they claim that they are a supporter of mental health and stuff. School, let me just fucking talk about school for a second. School is literally diving and slicing into your personal life. Like, it's like, fuck you, fuck your family time, fuck this. School is just at the back of your head. You have a quiz that's coming up. You're not gonna be able to like chill out at all. You're just gonna be thinking about that. So what I wanna tell you guys, everything will happen. You will get that assignment done on the right time. You will get your project done with your team on the right time. You can do all of that without fucking sacrificing your mental health. I'm gonna tell you some things you're probably doing right now that are not so much more in line with what I'm talking about. You're probably not giving yourself enough breaks or shortening your study breaks because you're just like, oh, I really need to get this done, this assignment's due, blah, 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 blah. Or you're probably just like overworking yourself because you're trying to get recognized. You're trying to prove something to someone else, like, hey, look at me, I'm an overperformer, blah, 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 right? You don't really need to do that. Having that personality that you just want to please everyone, if this really resonates with you, I suggest that you just kind of do some work inwards and just see that, like, yo, you're replaceable. Sorry, this is a very tough reality check, but you're replaceable. If you just put in constant effort into whatever you're doing, it's gonna happen. You don't have to not hang out with your friends here and there, and you don't have to ignore your parents for a while. Sometimes, I guess that's necessary. Sometimes. And that too, only if you've been slacking all year long. So if you haven't, that's not even necessary. This goes into my tip number two, which is you need to make more time for the things that matter most to you. So what the fuck does that mean? If you really like to go out and eat, you just love fucking going to a restaurant, you love going to cafes, you love doing stuff like that on the weekends, you love going to the river, don't give that shit up. You should actually be doing that on a weekly basis. It's fucking free, first of all. The fuck, going for a walk in Calgary during winter or fall is so therapeutic for you in your own head to think that you are supposed to sacrifice this stuff because you should rather be studying is fucked up. It's actually scientifically proven to not be efficient if you don't give yourself breaks. People will just hammer down their study schedule and they'll have one thing after another thing after another thing. And I've talked about this before in another Talk Tuesday where you have a do nothing day. And if you have a day where you allocate to hang out with your friends, go to a fucking pumpkin patch or something, if you have those little like things to look forward to in your weeks, seasonal depression will actually not be as prominent as it is in previous years, because guess what you've been doing? You've been depriving yourself of every little sight of happiness. Your brain automatically says, no, you don't deserve that. You're literally, you have a midterm in 3 weeks. So what? Don't get me wrong, I'm really not trying to say that you don't need to study. Time management, sure. But I'm saying, when you're doing the time management, you're figuring out your calendars, make sure you allocate time to like chill out, and don't just have like a block that says chill day. You should fucking write down in that day or those hours that you gave yourself a break exactly what you're gonna do and exactly what you wanna do. If you wanna go for a walk, if you wanna go drive to Starbucks and grab a coffee, write that down, because I guarantee when that break comes along, you're just gonna end up plopping on your bed or your sofa and scrolling through TikTok for hours, which is so unproductive because that's not giving your brain a break. Your brain needs a real break. Seasonal depression correlates with the time of the year that's really busy for a lot of people as well, so it's no surprise that a lot of people feel this way. Yes, it has to do with the seasons, obviously, but it has to do with what the season's associated with, which is, you know, work and hecticness. I highly suggest just being fucking easy on yourself and just having that time where you are actually taking a real break, not a half-assed TikTok break. I've actually seen a lot of this already in my own personal life. Just as a quick story time, I was so fucking hard on myself throughout university. Like, I didn't hang out with friends at all. I literally would study and I would just study in my free time. If I ever did have an extra break or I just finished writing a quiz and I did want to chill, I would literally watch Netflix, which is the stupidest thing I could ever do. Yeah, once in a while it's fine, but not every fucking time. So I didn't actually give myself the time of the day, and that's why I started feeling all burnt out and depressed really easily. Like, I think by November I'd be like, fucking winter, bro, fuck. When winter's not even ugly, it's actually so gorgeous. Like, we're very lucky to have like snow and shit. But as soon as I started making plans with my friends and giving myself that extra day to just hang out, I was so much more productive with all my tasks. And like, now I'm working, but now I'm noticing a difference too, because I'm not letting the stress get to me. The two main things that I changed in my own head was like, hey, work, I'm gonna set my boundaries a little bit. Secondly, with everything else, like school wise, it's like when you need to take a break, take that break. Do it, because really helping you in your long term. The third little tip that I shall give you, and it's also another thing that I've also implemented, when you're meditating more and more and more consistently every single day, you start to get more in tune with your body and you start to understand what your body needs. For example, I now sleep properly because I listen to my body. So my body will literally tell me sometimes, and it's like 8:30 and it's like, I'm fucking tired. I don't go on my phone scrolling for hours like an idiot. I actually sit down and I actually like go to bed. I pass out. And some days, like the next day, I'll be fine. I can work on editing till like 11 because I love editing. So it's like, I can keep working on all my other stuff till like 11 p.m. and I'm fine. Like, your body and your mind are not gonna stick to one strict schedule. So for you to be more in tune with your body, just so you know what you need, is so important. And that's like a deeper level of self-care. Starting to meditate and stuff definitely helps. The fourth tip, this one's actually so important. It's something I discovered. It's a really cool tip. You know how we all wait till the weekends to have like our like chill day, or like it's like, oh my god, like it's Friday almost here. Why don't we do that in the middle of the week? I get it, you know, you have like school and you have like work and people are like, Girlene, that's so stupid. Like, I work the next day. Hear me out. On a Wednesday, you promise yourself that you're gonna hit the gym or whatever, but you're not gonna go too off. You're gonna spend an extra 30 minutes in the sauna and you're gonna come back and you're going to play some sick lo-fi hip-hop beats, make yourself a coffee, have a little paint night with your brother or your family members, or by yourself. You're gonna have a paint night. You're gonna promise yourself a paint night. You could literally do this on like a Thursday or a Tuesday or a Wednesday, but I'm saying Wednesdays because it's split in the middle of the week. And what it really does is it informs your brain that like, you don't have to wait 5 fucking days before you can enjoy. I don't know what it is with the structure that we have, but we don't have to wait for the weekend to be happy. Like, I don't know why that's a thing, and because imagine going your whole life spending 5 days miserable and just 2 days where you're happy. That's so fucked up to me. I'm also acknowledging the fact that we all gotta work, so I totally understand that, like, you have to do the things that you don't want to do, and that's why naturally the days that are off are the days that are happier. I totally get that, but I'm saying it doesn't need to be that way. Go fucking have a movie night with your friends on a fucking Tuesday. Go do that. Go fucking do that with your friends. You don't need to wait for the weekend, bro. You can plan stuff and you can be just as efficient and effective, if not probably more, because you're actually happier. Tip number 5. And guys, I should really start writing these tips down, because I never remember what fucking number I'm on. It's fucking embarrassing, but whatever. Do things alone. A lot of the times, you know, you're trying to coordinate with, like, your friends or whatever. You're trying to, like, figure out when they're free. And how often does that happen? Pretty rare. You shouldn't rely on all your friends being available, because that shouldn't stop you from still having the day that you want. Go by yourself. Go by yourself. You know, it's funny, because it's actually on my bucket list to go eat somewhere by myself and go watch a movie by myself. I think it's a vibe. Us as humans being able to hang out with ourselves and have fun by ourselves is so crucial, and not only in just like fighting seasonal depression, but also in just spiritual growth and just being a better, happier, more vibrant human being. You being okay with your own thoughts to hang out with yourself and have a good time is so important. So throwing this tip out there, because seasonal depression comes in a time where everyone's super, super busy. Not everyone's always gonna be free when you're free, and vice versa. So you gotta plan stuff on your own. Never know what you're gonna find. You're never gonna know what you're gonna find. I discovered this sick ass park, and I literally pinned the location and sent it to Adbut, because I'm like, we're going. But if he isn't available, I'll go by myself. Tip number 6 on how to combat seasonal depression. Don't let the ideology that, like, just because you're studying or just because you're working and you're busy means that it's okay to just buy fucking junk food. Prioritize your eating. Meal prep every Sunday if you gotta do it. Don't let yourself fucking go eat junk food more than like twice a week, especially on like in a busy week. I'm a foodie, bro. I'm a foodie. I love snacks. I snack all the time when I'm studying. All I'm trying to say is your food intake during these times of the month, they're so directly correlated to your mood. It's insane. More in the winter months than summer. Like, don't fucking wait till summer to get the hot girl summer body. Bro, keep up your workout routine. Like, keep it up. Keep eating healthy throughout the year. These tips are gonna help you, because damn. You know, again, I always say this, if we're not gonna take care of ourselves, then no one else is gonna take care of ourselves. We're gonna have a great rest of the fall season and a great winter season. This was more of a casual talk and therapy for me. If you enjoyed this video and you want more content like this, please hit that subscribe button, like this video, and comment. Have an amazing, amazing day, and bye.